Okay, good morning everyone. So she has already told about the indications of AMT, that is amniotic membrane transplantation, and the commonest indication is just chemical or thermal burn. So in the initial stage, if this acute management is proper, then we can have this good outcome. But if the outcome is not good, then we can go for some procedures to repair the to for visual rehabilitation, all those things. So I will be talking for next 7 minutes on SLET. So what is SLET? So in limbal stem cell deficiency, ocular surface damage following thermal or chemical injuries results from limbal ischemia, and then subsequent loss of stem cells which are capable of repopulating the corneal epithelium. So these stem cells are not there in this limbal epithelium, and then a state of corneal limbal stem cell deficiency occurs if the number of limbal epithelial stem cells is depleted below a critical threshold level by trauma or by disease. So what is the treatment of limbal stem cell deficiency? That is, the only treatment is limbal stem cell transplantation. And a successful limbal stem cell transplantation can achieve a rapid surface healing with stable ocular surface, the aggression of corneal vascularization, and there will be no recurrent erosions or persistent epithelial defects, restoration of a smooth and optically improved ocular surface resulting in improved visual acuity and probably increased success for subsequent keratoplasty. So depending on the case, like that, if it is unilateral or bilateral, there are various treatment modalities. So in unilateral cases, we can go for conjunctival limbal autograft, cultivated limbal epithelial transplantation, and recently simple limbal epithelial transplantation. In bilateral cases, we can go for living related keratolimbal allograft or conjunctival limbal allograft, allogenic slate or clate, or sometimes we can go for COMET, that is cultivated oral mucosal epithelial transplantation. So what is this conjunctival limbal autograft? So early approach was that suppose this case was having this this preoperatively thermal injury and patient developed this partial LSCD along with this simblepharon. So I did this conjunctival limbal autograft from the other eye, and this is the post-op outcome after 1 year. So the advantages of conjunctival limbal autograft is that there is no chance of rejection, anything like that, but the disadvantage is that we are taking 3 to 4 clock hours of the limbal tissue from the opposite sides of the eye. So there is a possibility that it can lead to iatrogenic LSCD. So to avoid that, this Pellegrini et al, they first described conjunctival limbal epithelial transplantation, that is where they have taken less than 1 hour of limbal tissue and then they expand in the stem cell laboratory over a substrate, maybe it is fibrin glue, maybe it is amniotic membrane, and then after 2 weeks then they transplant over the diseased surface. So autologous, that means ex vivo cultivated limbal epithelial transplantation, that is SLET, and it is advantage is that it is very much predictive, and it is more conventional than CLAW and can be repeated from the donor eye. But the disadvantage is that it cannot be made in everywhere because of some issues with the biological laboratories, and this time for cultivation is 2 weeks, and it is quite expensive. That one stem cell laboratory costs near about 1.5 crore rupees. So to avoid those difficulties, this Sangwan et al. First described a technique which is called SLET, where it is a single stage procedure and needs less donor tissue, unlike CLAW, and does not need a stem cell laboratory for cell expansion as like in CLAT. And the multicenter and long-term results concluded that SLED promises to be an easy and effective technique for managing unilateral LSCD following ocular burns. So whenever we are managing such types of cases, we must try to achieve the following goals. So these are all these patients came after 1 year or 6 months after these things. Suppose if the patient, the ideal time for SLED is that after 3 months when this inflammation is subsided, and the eye should be wet surface. Otherwise, if it is a dry surface, then you cannot go for SLET. So if the first and primary goal is that re-establishment of the anatomical and physiological conditions of the ocular surface, and then the second goal is this restoration of the corneal clarity with visual acuity improvement. And to achieve these goals, we must have some surgical plans that include simblepharon correction along with limbal stem cell transplantation. So if this simblepharon is more than half of the lead margin, that means more than 15 centimeter, then we have to go for 15 millimeter, then we have to go for two-stage procedure. First, we have to release the simblepharon, then wait for 2-3 weeks, then go for limbal stem cell transplantation. So surgical steps, there are 3 steps for SLET: preparation of the recipient eye, limbal biopsy, donor limbal stem cell preparation from the other healthy eye, and then distribution of the limbal transplants over the AMG. So preparation of the recipient eye. So 360 degree conjunctival peritomy should be done first, and it should be done 2 to 3 millimeters away from the limbus. So you should not damage the limbus next. Sometimes this limbal tissue may be there inside this diseased area, so we should not damage it. So the peritomy should be done 2 to 3 millimeters away from the limbals, and they remove the conjunctival pannus with superficial keratectomy. Hemostasis can be achieved by using cautery or by adrenaline. Then human amniotic membrane placed over the bare ocular surface and glued using fibrin glue. In all the cases, we should use this blunt spatula, otherwise you may have, you will end up in perforation of the globe. Then amniotic membrane is placed, so you have to use this two-fold technique, that is this first inferior half and then second, this superior half should be glued. And then limbal biopsy from the donor, that is the donor limbal stem cell preparation from the other healthy eye. As I mentioned, that slate is inferior, that means initially it was a uniocular procedure. So other eye should be healthy. And we have to take a donor from the other healthy eye. And first we have to make this bleb by injecting normal saline or BSS, and then take just limbal tissue, which should be at least 1 millimeter inside the cornea. We can cut it from the corneal side also, but if I go for from the corneal side, then we can just perforate the cornea also. So better to go from the limbal side or bulbar side. And then we have to preserve it in BSS. Then the limbal graft is cut into 10 to 12 pieces and then placed on the surface of the amniotic membrane just inside the limbus. Suppose that this is the case where we have cut these limbal tissues, then we placed this, prepared this bed, and then cut this limbal tissues over the amniotic membrane just inside the limbus, so that this limbus, this limbal tissues will grow both centrally as well as centripetally as well as peripherally. And then that will be just giving rise to this normal epithelium. It should be, that means it should be, we should fix it by using fibrin glue, or sometimes we can use a double layer of amniotic membrane to prevent such dislocation, especially in children. So here I just put the BCL, here I put another layer of amniotic membrane. This was a small child. So these limbal tissues are quite expensive, quite, that means precious for them. So that's why I put this, again, another piece of amniotic membrane. So this is the schematic representation. This first, this is the, I have to prepare this, that means release the simplepharon, remove the pannus, and then prepare the that means recipient eye, then put the amniotic membrane, then remove the limbal biopsy, site from the, and then cut it into 10 to 12 pieces, and then I separate it, and then put it over the amniotic membrane, then I put another piece of amniotic membrane over that. So this is, there is, so this is, this, this is a patient who had this 9 months old child. This patient, initially this patient was, that means referred to us from Assam, and then they told that this eye, nothing can be done. So we did this, and after doing that slate technique, so in children we should go for this, using this tarsography and put this simulacrum ring or conformer. And this is the picture after 2 weeks. This is the picture after 6 weeks. And this is the picture after 1 year. So this is the donor eye now. So I am just keeping this slate with simulacrum. So postoperative care is that topical antibiotics till defects heal, topical corticosteroids, prednisolone acetate 1%, tear substitutes, especially if possible preservative free, topical cycloplegics, oral immunosuppressants if it is an allogenic slate, follow up closely till 6 to 8 weeks and thereafter monthly basis. So how does slate really work? So definitions of success broadly relate to reversal of the features of ocular surface failure. and autologous slate has been for unilateral limbal stem cell deficiency multivariate analysis showed that the overall success rate of slate in this study was 85.7%, which remains above 80% of the final follow-up, and this is similar to or better than most of the published CLAW or CLAT. So to summarize, autologous limbal transplantation is the treatment of choice in unilateral, total or partial LSCD, and there is no need of allogenic procedure in this condition. Slate over CLAT as the preferred surgical technique, not only because it is effective, but also because it offers many other advantages, such as being one single stage, more affordable and technically feasible in a resource limited setting, and it is quite reproducible. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Dr. Tuhin.